Bonjour à tous, hi everyone, and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 4, Leçon L. And in this lesson, we'll have the pleasure to see together what we call les pronoms COI. Okay, les pronoms COI. So, well, let's say that it's the second part of les pronoms COI. O, complément d'objet, okay? So if you didn't watch the previous lesson, well, maybe it would be better to do so that you could understand maybe more clearly the whole thing, okay? But then still, we're starting right now. So, les pronoms complément d'objet direct. So we'll start with une question, a question, okay? So we'll see. It's a basic question, okay? You get, tu parles à ton frère. Okay, parler is to talk. Tu parles, you talk, to your brother, à ton frère. Okay, so if we have a look at the elements in this sentence, the first part or the first element is tu, okay, and that's the subject of the sentence, tu, all right. Then the second element is parle, okay, and that's the verb. So it's ending like that because you've been conjugating this verb according to tu, okay, but it's a verb here. And then we've got this last part here, à ton frère. So that's what we call complément, so it will come to complete the sentence, okay? And it's objet, okay? So be careful, it's really what we call a grammatical object. So it's not an object, because in that case, it's a good example, because it's a person, okay? But then it's a grammatical object, and it's indirect, because you've got this preposition à here, okay? So in the previous lesson, we saw the direct ones, okay? They were without any preposition, okay? But then in this lesson, it's indirect because you've got the preposition à here, okay? And it will change the things. So let's see the question. You can ask the question, so it's the same. Tu parles à ton frère? Okay, and then the answer that you could give, of course, would be oui, je parle à mon frère. But let's say that in most of the cases in French, we won't repeat this à mon frère part, okay? We'd rather use pronouns just to avoid repeating this complément d'objet indirect, okay? So we'll see how they go. As usual in French, we will have the difference between the masculine form, the feminine form, and the plural form, okay? And here, just to start, we'll start with masculine singular, okay? Masculine singular form will be lui, okay? U-I, lui, lui, all right? Féminin singulier, so feminine form and the singular form here, it will be lui. So it's quite easy to memorize, to remember, okay, because it is the same form for the masculine and the feminine form, okay? And then for the plural form, so third person of the plural, to be more precise, it will be leur, okay? So masculine singular, third person of the singular, lui, féminin singulier, feminine singular form, third person of the singular, lui, and then the plural form, third person of the plural, leur. Okay? Let's see now the same question. Okay? Tu parles à ton frère. Okay? And the idea in that case, of course, is to avoid repeating this part here, so complément d'objet indirect, and to replace it with the pronoun, okay? So first, we know that it's indirect because we've got the preposition here. We know here that it's masculine because it's brother, okay? And then we've got the information here because it's ton, all right? So we've got all the elements just to reply using the pronoun. Oui. Je lui parle. Okay? So the only thing you should really think about here is the position, so you should remember, as I said previously, that the pronoun in French will be placed before the verb. So, je lui parle. Oui, je lui parle. Alright? And then we could have, well, basically the same question, but then this question would be like it is here, at the near future. So if you didn't see the lesson regarding the near future, maybe it would be more useful for you to watch it. But still, the near future, it's a way to construct the future, but at the present tense with the verb aller, to go. You are going to speak or talk, okay, to your brother. Okay, so you are going to, but then the important thing in that case is that you've got two verbs. Okay, you've got aller here, to go, and then you've got parler, to speak or to talk. Okay, and when you've got two verbs, then for the pronoun that you would like to use, you will have to put it just before the second verb. Oui, je vais lui parler. Okay, so I'm not telling you that it should be between, because that's the case here, but then between these two verbs you could put many, many things, okay, like adverbs or other things. Okay, so remember that this pronoun lui should be before the second verb. All right, so now we'll see these pronouns, but then for all the persons. Okay, for the first person of the singular, it will be me. Second person of the singular, te. Then third person, like we saw, so masculine and feminine, I only put one, so lui, because it's the same. First person of the plural, nous. Second person of the plural, vous. Third person of the plural, leur. Okay, me, te, lui, nous, vous, leur. Alright? So let's see examples now. So he's talking to me. Il me parle. Okay, remember, me, and then before the verb. Il me parle. He's talking to you. Il te parle. Il lui parle. I don't know why lui is still white. Well, maybe it was a mistake from my... Yeah, it is a mistake. It should be orange, but then still. Il lui parle. Okay. Il nous parle. Il vous parle. Il leur parle. All right. Il me parle. Il te parle. Il lui parle. Il nous parle. Il vous parle, il leur parle. Okay, so these examples are with one verb, okay, and then I've been rewriting the same sentence, but then at the near future, okay, with the two verbs, and then we can see how they go now. Il va me parler, he's going to talk to me. Il va me parler, so remember, you know, me before the second verb. Il va te parler, he's going to talk to you. Il va lui parler, he's going to talk to her, or he's going to talk to him, okay? Il va nous parler, he's going to talk to us. Il va vous parler, he's going to talk to you. Il va leur parler, he's going to talk to them, okay? Il va me parler, il va te parler, il va lui parler, il va nous parler. Il va vous parler, il va leur parler. That's it. Congratulations if everything is clear. It was leçon L. Be sure to find more lessons there on youtube.com/imagier, and then the website is here and it's waiting for you. Okay, bye bye.